Hello everyone, this is Gargi Shekhar from Maya Group of Colleges, Silakwit, Dehradun. In the YouTube channel of Youth Education System, on the subject of Elementary Agricultural Engineering, today's topic is Overview of Farm Power in India. So first of all, understand what is the meaning of farm power. Farm power is nothing but the power which we are using on the farms of agriculture. Now, basically, you should understand that farm power is an essential input in agriculture for timely field operations for increasing production and productivity of the land. Farm power is used for operating different types of machineries like tillage, planting, plant protection, harvesting, and threshing machineries. Basically, power stands for the working ability. So whatever power we are using in the farms is termed to be the farm power. Now understand that farm power in India is very important for the mechanization. You can observe in the given figure there are different types of machineries which we use in the farming systems, and that is very important for us. So the sources of farm power, if we talk about, there are different sources of farm power available in India, which are first of all the human power, then comes the animal power, then is the mechanical power, which includes the tractors, power tillers and oil engines, then is the electrical power, renewable energy, which includes biogas, solar energy and wind energy. Now you can observe here that there is paddy necessary nursery collections, nursery transportation and paddy transplantation over here in the figures. All are done with the help of humans. So the human power is a very important source of power. It is the main source of operating small implements and tools at the farms. Stationary work like chaff cutting, lifting, water threshing, winnowing, etc. are done by manual labors. An average man can develop maximum power of about 0.1 HP for doing farm work. Now you should understand, the next is the animal power. Plowing of the land, plowing of the land with horses or with bullocks, bullock carts, when we are using it, and then Persian wheels for the water lifting, all these devices are running on the animal power. There are many much more things we can do with the help of animal power. So the first thing you should know is the power developed by an average pair of bullock is about 1 HP for usual farm work. The bullocks are employed for all types of farm works in all seasons. Besides bullocks, there are other animals like camels, buffaloes, horses, donkeys, mules, elephants that are also used in some places. The average force a draft animal can exert is nearly 1/10 of its body weight. So if you need to calculate the average force, you must know the body weight of the animal. So now we'll be talking about the next type of power, that is the mechanical power. Broadly speaking, mechanical power includes stationary oil engines, tractors, power tillers and self-propelled combines. Internal combustion engines, that is also called as IC engine, is a good device for converting fuel, liquid fuel into useful work, that is in mechanical work. The thermal efficiency of the diesel engine varies from 32% to 38%, whereas that of petrol engine varies from 25% to 32%. In modern days, almost all the tractors and power tillers are operated by diesel engines. The diesel engines are used for operating irrigation pumps, flour mills, then oil gunnies, the cotton gins, chaff cutters, sugarcane crushers, threshers, winnowers, etc. Now we'll be talking about the different types of engines we already discussed in the previous lectures. The first is the two-stroke engine, then comes the 18-cylinder two-stroke engines, four-stroke engines plus pumps, threshers, tractors of different types. All these are a part of farm powers we are using. Now we'll be talking about the electrical power. You can observe here electrical motors of different types, chaff cutters which are motor driven, electrical motor driven pump with chaff cutters. These are certain kinds of electrical power we are using on the farms. So if we talk about it, electrical power is used mostly in the form of electrical motors in the farms. It is clean, quiet and smooth running. Its maintenance and operation needs less attention and care. Electrical power is used for water pumping, dairy industries, cold storage, farm products processing, fruit industries and many other similar things. So that is all about the electrical power. Sometimes we also use renewable energies, and this is being very common nowadays since we need renewable energies. Solar electrical panels with a grid from which we can harness the solar energy is the most common type of renewable energy we are using. It is the energy mainly obtained from the renewable resources like sun, wind, biomass, etc. Biogas energy, wind energy and solar energy are used in agriculture and domestic purposes with suitable devices. Renewable energy can be used for lighting, cooking, water heating, then space heating, water distillation, food processing, water pumping, electric generations. This type of energy is inexhaustible in nature. So that is all about the renewable energies. The wind farms, you can observe, these are the windmills which are used. There are biogas plants which is made at the farm power stations, and these are all used as the farm power sources. Now we'll be talking about the uses of renewable energy sources. Solar energy is used as solar dryers, lanterns, cookers, solar stills, solar refrigeration, solar lightenings, etc. Wind energy is used for water pumping, electricity generation, etc. Biomass energy is used by the gasifiers to produce producer gas, pyrolysis, to produce liquid fuels and biogases, etc. Tidal energy is basically used for the electricity generation. You must know tidal energy is harnessed from the ocean. The upward and downward movements of the tides are basically termed to be the tidal energies. Then is the geothermal energy, the energy which we are obtaining from the land by the geographical thermal power stations is termed to be the geothermal energy. Heat and electricity production is done by this. So that is the basic farm powers we are using. And farm power also includes the farm mechanization. Basically, farm mechanization is the main concept of to apply the principles of engineering and technology to the agricultural operations in better way to increase the crop yield. This includes the development, application and management of all the mechanical aids for field operation, water control, material handling, storage and processes. The mechanical aid includes hand tools, animal drawn implements, power tillers, tractors, engines, electric motors, grain processing and howling equipments. So you can observe this is a thresher and it is used for the hectares of land. Now we'll talk about the scope of farm mechanization. The first scope is improved irrigation facilities, introduction of the high yielding varieties. The use of higher doses of fertilizers and pesticides have increased the scope of for greater farm mechanization. If machines are used, farmers and his animals are relieved from hard work. With the support of machines, farmers can do his job better and quicker. He will get more leisure and devote his time to other works. He can earn better living. So these are certain scopes of mechanizations. Now we'll be talking about the benefits of farm mechanization. It is the timeliness of operation, that is, it saves the time. It has precision in operation, so there is a precision of operation. There is improvement of the work environment. The enhancement of safety is the major benefit of farm mechanization. There is reduction of drudgery of labor. There is reduction of loss of crops and food products. Increased productivity of lands. It is increasing the economic return to the farmers. It has improved dignity of the farmers. And finally, the progress and prosperity in the rural areas is obtained with the with the farm mechanization in the fields. So now we'll be discussing certain constraints of the farm mechanization. First constraint is it is not good for the small land holdings. It has less investing capacity of the farmers, which is a constraint for the farm mechanization. Adequate availability of draft animals makes farm mechanization less popular in the farmers. Lack of suitable farm machinery for different operations. There is less awareness for the farmers to use suitable types of machines. There is lack of repair and surfacing facilities for machines. Since the machines are new for the farmers, their repair and servicing facilities are not being aware to the farmers. There is lack of trained manpower, because any farm mechanization or farm machinery needs skilled labors. So there is a lack of the trained manpower, or skilled manpower is lacking. Lack of coordination between research organization and manufacturers. Now you should know that there should be a coordination between the research organizations and manufacturers. If it is not present, it becomes a constraint for adopting the farm mechanization. Then high cost of the machines is the major constraint for the farm mechanization. Since our farmers are little poor, so they need very cost efficient machines. High cost of machines are not adopted from them. There is inadequate quality control of the machines. So that is all about the farm power and mechanization. We'll be talking in the next session about different types of farm machineries. Thank you. Have a nice day.